the level 58 boost and botting is out of control. Here we go.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Willie here.
Here we go.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Willie here. I wasn't going to do this video initially because I know it's something that Blizzard have shown time and again. They just aren't really willing to commit resources to stopping this kind of thing happening. But
that's true.
The amount of damage caused to the game by the level 58 boost, and especially the new wave of bots which are taking advantage of this in TBC Classic, is much worse than I ever expected it to be.
Fuck.
Most of the footage here from the open world was done within the space of 1 hour on a Thursday morning. I just want to say that to give you an idea of how very, very easy it is to find bots doing this. Literally every single bot without fail was a level 58 boosted character. The limitation of one per account for bots is completely irrelevant. As expected for them, it's just a huge time save from actually having to level. The restriction of no Draenei or Blood Elf equally doesn't matter whatsoever. It's an extra $40 or whatever it is they pay for this service on top of their sub fee. This is so, so much extra money for Blizzard. Even if these characters are being banned within the space of a month, the time it takes them to break even is next to nothing. Also, the boost has done so much harm to the old world. It just feels dead. People aren't out there leveling and questing anymore as they used to be. Whenever people say how much Cataclysm ruined the game because it changed the open world, just seems more and more BS the more I hear it. In Classic, so many people chose to boost past all the content, and now in TBC, you can do the same by giving, instead of money in-game to a mage, real money to Blizzard. You know what else? Do you have a T-Boo's Blazing Longsword, or you bought one in Classic? That incredibly special and unique item. It's on the box of...
But people said it would be cost prohibitive to buy boosts for botters, not you. Yeah, I know. I didn't say that. I'm on record in three videos saying the opposite. Yeah, people are dumb. Yeah, people are stupid. Yeah, that's a big shocker. Yeah, people are dumb.
Of the original game. It's always been heralded for its mystical rareness, and to this day is worth an absolute fortune on retail. Yeah, it's kind of worthless on Classic now, and it's getting...
To be fair, stay safe. You said you didn't care about the boost when it came out, but I'm glad you changed your stance. You almost triggered an aneurysm. You almost just popped a fucking blood cell. Blood vessel in my brain. You almost just popped one.
And cheaper by the day.
Almost.
You know the bots inside Blackrock Depths, the rogues, the ones that have plagued the instance with pickpocketing for well over a year now? Well, don't you worry, they're still going good and strong. In fact, they even got a raise in TBC because Tibu's Blazing Longsword, yep, the epic fiery sword, drops from the heavy junk boxes that they pickpocket all day long in the TBC patch that we're playing on. So if you ever got hold of one of these as a trophy in Classic, intending to just hold on to it for the sake of it because you could never get one on retail, or to...
Oh, no. Wow, wow, wow. This is fucked up. Holy shit.
Try and sell it at a later date, then... That's one very expensive paperweight, I'm afraid. Well, at least you don't lose money until you sell it. Right? Right? Anyway, let's take a fly around the good old continent of Outland and see if we can find ourselves any average farming enjoyers. By the way, I reckon there are a good few gold farmers in here as well. It's just that with some of them, they either look like stolen or sold characters, because my god, we're going to be seeing some interesting item and talent choices that I quite literally refuse to believe somebody could have played the game as much as these people are geared and actively have made that choice unless they are huffing industrial quality paint thinner prior to logging in.
That's
so,
what I do every time.
Chatra, Silmia Lake, or is
that
like...
That's actually what I have to do to play TBC at this point. I have to huff paint thinner.
Let's call it the Druid Nature Reserve.
The only thing that gets me through the raids.
Which is usually about half a dozen or so of our fairy friends happily farming away after those moats of water. We usually have some warlocks here too, and the occasional rogue. I found all three. Druids are good, especially feral due to leader of the pack healing, and aquatic form for, well, breathing underwater. Locks are good too because they can just cast that spell. And mobs here also respawn insanely quickly.
Yeah.
This place was very busy for a Thursday morning, I must say. After this, I decided to head up north to the Dead Mire, another great farming spot. The giants here can be herbed upon death for a range of different items, including Terracone, which I don't know about your server, but for me, they're over 6 gold each. That's a lot. This is a good spot for farming primal life as well, and also has a bunch of mining and various herb nodes here as well.
I'm curious, how long do you have to bot to make your money back? Let me see. I'm gonna Google buy classic WoW gold. I did this calculation before TBC came out, and it was like 15 hours. You have to effectively bought for 15 hours to make the RMT value of the money you threw down, the $40 boost and the $15 for 1 month sub. It was like 15 hours. So I don't know. Okay, I'm gonna go to some random classic WoW gold buying site. Let me see. Let me pick a server. I'm gonna do Fairlina Alliance. Okay. Okay. And by the way, you should not buy gold. We're doing this for informative purposes only. Okay. So 1,000 gold is $20 USD. Is that true? That seems really high. 1,000 gold, $20. That's what it says, I guess. True. Okay. Well. Any gold buyers in the chat? Okay, that's about what it is. Okay, nice. Thanks, gold buyers. Okay, so in order to get your, it's like 10 to 15. Okay, let's say it's 15. I'm gonna say it's 15. Okay, I'm gonna say it's 15. So in order to get your bot account up and running, it costs $40 for the boost plus $15 for 1 month sub, and you can bot for 1 month. Okay, let's do 1 month. So you're talking $55 divided by 15 so wait, is this actually fucking true, chat? What this means? Yeah, this is 3600 gold exactly. How much gold are these bots making per hour? Now we need to know that. How much gold are the bots making per hour? What, like probably like 75 gold per hour? How much? I have no idea. How much? 100? 200? Doing what? 200 gold an hour? No shot. No fucking shot. I'm gonna say 100, okay? I'm gonna say 100. Okay, so yeah, so it's easy. 100 is easy. They have to bot for 36 hours to make back their investment, and then anything beyond 36 hours of botting, they're making profit. That's the way you look at this. Yeah, they just if as long as they can bot for more than 36 hours at a rate of 100 gold per hour, then I do 200. Well, then it's like 18 hours. If your bot is farming 200 gold an hour, if you bought 18 hours, you've cut even, and anything more than that, you're making gold if you're RMTing. It's incredibly worth, right?
If you've leveled here in, well, the past month or so, probably longer than that at this point, then you've probably seen people running eagerly to try and herp anything that you've killed as soon as you do. But there was only about 4 or 5 people here at the time, including some regular players, yes. I thought at least, so that's not really a problem, is it? Next, we're going to head over to Void Ridge. I think you're going to like this. Came across another druid who was about as human as the T-1000, and I was going to report him anyway, and then I saw this talent choice in particular, and even if he wasn't a bot, I still would have been tempted to report him just for this alone. Regardless, we went over a bit more east, and you'll be glad to know that I'm kidding. Oh my god, there's so many bots around this one spot. This was unreal. They're all farming Motes of Shadow here. I remember doing weapon skill on my paladin not so long ago, and I thought this place was just really busy because, you know, popular farm spot. But as per usual, and as we've seen so far,
not only botting ruined the game for people on European servers, there are 3 to 5 servers going to be dead in the next weeks because of faction balance. For example, what is it, Emerald Sanctuary Horde are going to transfer the next upcoming week. Yeah, I mean, the two biggest issues right now, well, I was going to say botting and the level 58 boost, but really the axiom of the issue is the level 58 boost, because bots, the point of this video is bots are super egregiously taking advantage of the 58 boost. When I say the 58 boost has been bad for this game, it's been so bad for this game. Every time I say that, people are like, oh, stay safe. They're in my chat, right? You know, how? How is the 58 boost bad? Name one reason why. How is it bad? Man, like, it's been so fucking bad. It has you're talking about the faction imbalance. It has super drastically contributed to the faction balance, the 58 boost, because it made rerolling Horde really, really easy, right? And everyone wants to be Horde in TBC. Like, there has been, at this point, like a 14% population shift from Alliance to Horde in the last 2 months of TBC. And then on top of that, the botters are using it to farm a fuck ton of gold.
Oh, everyone, everyone was a boostie here. Loaded up on BOE gear, and most of them were even level 70s. Your druids, warlocks, and a few rogues in the mix as well. I decided to pop on Click to Move, as is tradition here, it appears, and join in on the fun a bit. I even got an applause from one of them, so, well, that was nice, wasn't it? And all the Voidwalkers that spawn here are on Hyperspawn, just like the eels in Silmia Lake that we saw a little bit ago. And this is all in the open world, imagine. In Classic, at least the majority was inside Instance. This is just from me flying from one spot to another, which I know are pretty heavily botted, in the morning, in one go. This would be so easy to get rid of if actual human game master...
Here is the reason why bots didn't bot so much in the open world in Classic WoW. It's because if you are running a bot in the open world, it's very easy for other players to notice you and right-click report you, and then you get banned. Thus, they hid inside of instances where there's a smaller chance of being reported by other actual human players. Now, in Classic TBC, it's super easy to bot open world because no one plays Classic TBC. No one's going to report you because no humans actually play this game because everyone quit. That's why. So it's just bots fucking everywhere, man.
Masters were employed to log into the game and look directly, not to rely upon automation or player reports to sort this out. Why do they have to rely on player reports when we're already paying them? What exactly?
They don't sell the gold. They sell the gold to people that log in once a week and raid log. That's it.
Are we paying for here? You want one big reason why Classic Fresh is gonna flop? Go and rewind the last few minutes of this video and imagine how a player feels when they want to try and farm some gold for raid consumables or to level a professional to buy a BOE, and they're met with this. Expect this with Fresh Classic, by the way, when it happens. Expect a billion-dollar company to value people shitting on the economy for their extra dollars as much as you, the loyal player. Because we had 18 months of Classic. Botters have their plans perfected, they have all their testing done, the gold farms programmed and ready to fire up, they know what triggers bans, and they're gonna totally infest the game once again while not enough is ever done about it. Let's round this out with some dungeons, shall we? They're always popular. Of course, BRD is as popular as ever, even with rogues being able to get T-boos now. Obviously, they never have to leave the instance, so you can't actually report them unless you whisper them something and then right-click and report off that. Yes, there's even places to sell inside the dungeon, so...
Here's the weird thing, okay? I actually can't blame people for botting, because it's so easy, and the chances of getting caught are so low, like, it's so effective. And they're probably, like, most botters, I don't know, you live in some fucking third world country, you're paying, like, you botting WoW is paying for food for your fucking family, right? If you live in fucking Indonesia or whatever the fuck, right? Can I be mad at some guy botting Classic WoW to pay for food for his family? Of course not. Of course not. Can I even be mad at people for buying gold? If anyone here in chat is buying gold, can I be mad at you for buying gold, considering it is so fucking efficient and cheap? It's such a good way, like, it's so value. It's so fucking value. I honestly don't even hold it against you guys. If anyone here buys gold, I actually don't even give a fuck if you're buying it. To be honest, it's so fucking value. Who am I mad at? Blizzard for not doing anything about it. It's on Blizzard. It always goes back to Blizzard. I'm not mad at the botters. I'm not mad at the buyers. I'm mad at Blizzard for doing fuck all to stop it. That's my take. It's Blizzard.
So, a bit inconvenient, isn't it? Would be good if somebody could, teleport to them, or maybe even teleport them out of the dungeon to some remote location and see how they react. And when they're all level 58, coincidentally. I hopped over to the slave pens where we came across another character, shall we say. Bellstrike Hood, Girdle of Ruination, Will of Edward the Odd, even Enchanted. Oh, sorry about the interruption of looking at the gear here. We've just got this constant stream of rogues coming out the instance. Imagine all those really good epics. He must have some good trinkets too, like Lifestone and... There's no way. This has to be a wind-up. You can't actually be serious. Blimage? I know the item's purple. But you probably want something with something.
You know the sad part? Literally the only single way that Blizzard catches bots is if you guys do the work for them and report the bot. If these bots don't get in here, like, they have no automated bot detection software. They don't. And on top of that, they don't have hack detection software either. All through Classic, you could fly hack. You could legitimately fly hack all through Classic WoW. Remember when bots were doing it or boosters were doing it in Zul'Garub? And they're no clip hack, like they're no clipping underneath walls and picking herbs from underneath. The only way Blizzard catches these motherfuckers is if you guys report. Like you Blizzard is relying on you guys to be the henchmen. That's the fucking, and The fucking salt in the wound is exactly is that private servers hosted in fucking Belarus by some 17-year-old script kid has better anti-hack detection software than actual classic WoW. There is a really, really good there's a really good Dodgy Kebab video about this where he actually logged into like, I don't know, 6 different private servers and tried to hack on all of them. He booted up hacks, he was like fly hacking and teleport hacking on all of these different private servers. And all of them, to varying degrees, kicked him off and like automatically banned his account. And then he logs into Classic WoW, and he's just having a field day. Like, there's just nothing stopping you from doing it. That's the fucked up part about it. It's totally fucked up.
Thing known as stats on them. They're quite good.
It's crazy.
In fact, where's your boosted trinket? That would be better than this by a long way. Anyways, I hung outside the pens for a bit, and we had a steady stream of rogues and mages. Every single one of them being a boost, popping...
By doing this, sitting here, spending your free time. Think about this. He's spending his free time. And of course, he's making a YouTube video, but this is the premise, right? You sit here and spend your free time reporting bots for Blizzard, fixing the problem that they should have fixed on their own. By doing this, I hate to say it, you are literally Bobby Kotick's cuckold pussy bitch. Like, straight up. Their plan for stopping bots is not to spend money on it, but to have you guys get so outraged that you do it. That's the market plan.
In and out, there's probably some legitimate players in there as well. People actually boost slave pens and TBC for gold. In terms of what they're farming for level 60s, you can see talents on some rogues here that maxed out movement speed and their ability to reset vanish or just threat in general. I imagine they're just mining and herbing, your usual stuff. As for mages, I guess the gold farms in here are doable at level 60. I've seen clips in the past of mages which are pure bots farming through Maradon, so I wouldn't put it past them at this point. Finally, we headed over to the mana tombs, which had a similarly insane number of rogues on the slash who, when the damn thing decides to work, that is. This place is known for chest and mining routes. Yeah. And this is it. This is the impact of the boost and how many bots there are 3 months in. Now, I know regardless of a boost existing, Blizzard should be doing better nevertheless, but this is one of the reasons why a lot of people did not want it in the first place, because it was always going to be an issue. I don't know how I'd play as a more casual person who has had less time so far.
I'm gonna pause there. I'm gonna show you guys something real quick. Let's scroll down. Oh yeah, look at this. I made this 5 months ago. I made this like a couple days after BlizzCon. The level 58 boost will destroy classic TBC. This video got fucking mass downvoted. This has 45,000. This video got mass downvoted. People were so fucking mad about this. It's really quiet.
Purchase a level 58 boost once per WoW account, though if you wanted, there's nothing stopping you from making multiple WoW accounts and purchasing multiple level 58 boosts.
People literally told me, no one's gonna do that. Stay safe, it's only one per account. No one's just gonna make two accounts. What? I'm gonna read the comments. Let me take a look at this. Okay. You are ignoring the fact that all of the hogs who are willing to pump that much cash into gold generation have already done it all through classic via mage boosting and multi-boxing. They already have full rosters of alchemists tailoring ready to pump out TBC. This guy's so dumb. Let me take a look here. You have to keep buying new accounts for the boost, level the profession to spend time doing it. People can just pay gold for any item they want in the game and buy the gold. I don't think this will be as bad as you think. I don't think this will be as bad as you think. He's actually right. It was worse. No, he's actually 100% right. It was worse than I thought it was going to be. Ah, shit. Let me keep playing the Willy video. Depressing, bro.
Not to farm
it's depressing.
Up or to get crafted gear or epic fly.
It's actually a burden. Guys, it is actually such a burden to be right about everything all the time, but also have no one believe you. It just takes it out of you, guys. It's just so hard. It really is.
Farming out in the open world just seems so impossible to compete. Even status items like Tibus are getting worthless due to this. Try any of these spots I've been to on your server or doing a slash who on your server, provided you have some kind of population there, of course. I'm sure you will see something similar, especially the lake outside chat. You can probably get to that one really fast, and I swear it's like this all day, every day at the moment. But don't you worry, I'm sure the 6th monthly ban wave will hit in about 3 months or so, and then we'll be fine again, right? Yeah, that's it. That's the video. This is Blizzard, and this is your TBC. I'd like to talk about the possibility of the Fresh Classic soon.
Dude, even Willy has lost it. Like, Willy is the most, like, nice, optimistic guy, and even he's over it, man. Even you can tell, like, it's just like fucking clown world, fucking laughable at this point.
If you didn't know, it was put on the PTR again recently, and I find the idea that it could be seen crazy, and given that's why things are usually put on the PTR, maybe there's something to talk about there, but I don't think it's gonna really kick off whatsoever, even if Blizzard add in lots of...
So when Classic WoW came out, there was like a solid maybe 2 or 3 months where there were no bots because no one had scripted the bots yet. Like, it takes time to script a bot and work out all the kinks in the software and right. But going into Classic Fresh this time, all of the bots are already scripted. Like, it's like those bots are going to be ready to go on day one. Whereas last time, 2 years ago, we played Classic, there were no bots for the first couple months. It was fucking awesome. But yeah. Within a couple days, you're going to have mages botting Zul'Farrokh in the Classic Fresh 2.0.
Changes, including the ones they put on the survey. But we can talk about that soon. Sorry about the delays on the new stuff. As promised, it's mainly a bottleneck on my end of wanting to get the new PC sorted, and I want to make sure I can get everything looking as good as it can be. That's it, guys. Let me know your thoughts, if anything, about all of this. Thank you, as always, so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next one very soon.
Nice one, Willie.